Hello everyone, welcome to my new video. I am going to illustrate the experiment branch spectrometer for crystal structure analysis. Crystal is aggregate of sets of parallel equidistant atomic planes and interplanar distance is few angstrom unit. Thus, crystal can be considered as three-dimensional grating or space grating. In 1912, the scientist Lau first time suggested the use of crystal for X-ray diffraction. According to Lau, when X-ray beam is incident on crystal, it is diffracted by atomic planes in crystal. The detailed study of X-ray diffraction was done by two scientists, W. H. Bragg and W. L. Bragg, William Henry Bragg and William Lawrence Bragg. Bragg studied in detail theory of X-ray diffraction and put forth their own theory, which is very famous as Bragg's law. Bragg suggested the use of X-ray diffraction for crystal structure analysis, and in 1915, Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to them for analysis of crystal structure using X-ray diffraction. So this is the setup used by Bragg for their experimentation of crystal study. Now, while deriving the law, that is Bragg's law, Bragg made certain assumptions. Crystal is space grating, that is, it is aggregate of sets of parallel equidistant atomic planes. So it is three-dimensional grating or space grating. Atomic planes in crystal act like semi-transparent mirror. Since it is mirror, when X-ray beam is incident on crystal, the beam is reflected by atomic plane in crystal. So see, this is the diagram for derivation of Bragg's law. We can see here, these are the atomic planes. This d is the interplanar distance, and this 1, 2 written, it shows X-ray beam, and we can see the reflection of X-ray beam from successive atomic planes because it is semi-transparent mirror. So diffraction and reflection, they are interchangeable. So we can use either term, Bragg's reflection or Bragg's diffraction. So when the X-ray beam is incident on crystal, it is diffracted by atomic planes in crystal, and 2d sin theta equal to n lambda condition for Bragg, this is the Bragg's law, where d is interplanar distance, theta is glancing angle, you can see here theta, it is the angle between incident X-ray beam and atomic plane, that we call glancing angle, and n is integer, n is 1, 2, 3, etc. and it is first order, second order, third order, maxima respectively. So Bragg's law is the principle used to study crystal structure, and that setup used for crystal structure analysis is known as Bragg's X-ray spectrometer. So what is the setup for Bragg's X-ray spectrometer? So obviously, first we require source of X-ray. So this is the X-ray tube or Coolidge tube, or we also call it as a X-ray source. Now this is turntable or rotating table, and the crystal is mounted on this rotating table. So when this table is rotated, see, the crystal can also be rotated. This is the X-ray beam incident on crystal, and theta is the glancing angle. When X-ray beam is incident on crystal, it is diffracted by atomic planes in crystal. Now we know that X-rays are invisible, so the diffraction pattern we cannot directly view using telescope. So to study diffraction pattern, we require some detector. So we use ionization chamber as detector. Now we know that when X-rays are incident in ionization chamber, or they are passed through ionization chamber, the X-rays produce ionization and give current that we call ionization current. Now this ionization chamber can also be rotated like this. See, this ionization chamber can be rotated around the crystal. Now the diffracted X-rays, they are passed through ionization chamber. They produce ionization, and you can see here we get current and we record the current. Now the current produced in ionization chamber is directly proportional to intensity of X-rays. So this current value gives us intensity of diffracted X-ray beam. Now we have seen this ionization chamber can be rotated around the crystal. It is because, suppose we have here ionization chamber, where is my cursor? And if your X-ray beam is here, which is shown by the red line, then you cannot get the correct value of ionization current. So we have to rotate the ionization chamber, and by rotating the ionization chamber, we find the position of ionization chamber where we get maximum value of current. See here, this is the direction of diffracted X-ray, and if at this position, if we have ionization chamber, here we get maximum value of current, or it gives correct value for intensity of X-ray. So this is the construction of Bragg's spectrometer. So now we set some value of glancing angle, let it be theta 1. Now by rotating the ionization chamber, we find the position to give maximum value of current, and we record the current I1. Now by rotating this turntable, we change the value theta and we adjust to next value theta 2. Again by rotating ionization current, we find position for maximum current and record the value I2. Again we rotate the table, adjust next value theta 3. Again we rotate this chamber and find the maximum value of current, that is I3, and so on. So by continuously rotating this turntable, we change the value of theta, that is glancing angle, and we record the current in ionization chamber. Thus we record ionization current for different glancing angles. And now we plot a graph of ionization current versus glancing angle. So this is the graph. Now ionization current, it gives intensity. So we have the graph of intensity versus 2 theta.